Indiana educators force a 7-year-old to eat his own vomit. Sarah Seymour, Deborah Knipe. Here they are, the two educators responsible for making a child eat his own vomit while others watched. Authorities said the video showed the student seated at a table in the cafeteria. The boy was eating his lunch and then stood up, appearing to gag on his food. Seymour, life skills teacher, appeared to tell him to sit down, police said. Seymour allegedly told the child that if he vomited, he would be required to eat what he threw up. Again, according to police. Taylor, a life skills teacher, was present, gave the boy a tray, the release says. Then, police said the child vomited on the tray and the table. Knipe, a life skills instructional aide, allegedly handed the boy a spoon. Both Seymour and Knipe stood at each side of the child while he was forced to use the spoon to eat the vomit and then clean up the rest with paper towels, police said. Kristen Mitchell, Megan King were present, witnessed the incident. Seymour and Knipe arrested Wednesday, released the same day. The termination process for them has already begun. The reporting from NBC News. Brownsburg police secured the video by warrant April 12th. The abuse, which occurred in February at Brown Elementary, depicted here with the superintendent, Jim Snap. BCSC Superintendent Jim Snap said, quote, as educators, protecting the safety and welfare of our students is at the core of who we are. We are deeply saddened by the actions of these staff members and will work in conjunction with our local law enforcement as they move forward with possible criminal charges. And here are the charges. Sarah Seymour, age 27, Deborah Knipe, 63, Julie Taylor, 48, Kristen Mitchell, 38, and Megan King, 24, were all charged with misdemeanor failure to report. Brownsburg police said Wednesday on Facebook, Seymour and Knipe were also charged with felony neglect of a dependent. NBC News again. The abuse has amassed enormous criticism, much of which deems that not enough has been done to rectify the incident. And there you see just some of it. My wife taught special needs students for 30 years. It takes a certain temperament to perform the necessary task. I don't think I could have done it. Apparently, these people couldn't either. Too bad they didn't realize that and resign before they hurt young people. In what world would any school be allowed to treat a child this way? Shouldn't be just staff punishment, but honestly, the school as a whole should be investigated. I'm sure this isn't the only incident. They just happened to get caught this time. Close this school. I don't care what they say, the actions in line with. Shut this school down. This wasn't one event. Meanwhile, Brown Elementary maintains a much different image of their care on their official website. Looks darling, doesn't it? Keeping education a priority by promoting health and encouraging physical and social wellness in a safe and nurturing environment for students and families, anything but. And it's again, and I tend to do this, and it's probably not fair. It's Monday morning quarterbacking, I think they call it. But when I look at the superintendent's statement, I mean, we're talking about an incident that happened in February, a warrant sworn out in April, the delay, all these people involved. That tells me something, Bennie, about the culture here. Because if I was just a volunteer aide, the whole thing would have been exposed instantly. They would have thrown me out of the school, but that's okay. And so I think that the comments from some in the community online saying close the school and there's what else is there, aren't they appropriate and fair?
Yeah, I mean, seriously, like, if you're at the point where something like this is happening and every adult in the room isn't, like, freaking out about it, like, because, like this is so nasty. This is disgusting. This is, like, absolutely disgusting on, like, two layers. First, it's just, like, immediately, like, physically disgusting. But then there's, like, how, like, monstrous of a person do you have to be psychologically to not only force somebody to eat their own vomit, but specifically a child, right? Like, I don't know if you know this about kids. Kids throw up, right? If you're watching and you don't know, kids throw up a lot. It's like a whole entire thing, you know? And you should, if you're an adult, understand that, recognize that, have empathy for them, right? You know, they're just kids. But instead, you have a bunch of people who have this mentality of like, oh no, they're just kids, right? So it's either they're just kids, we should have empathy for them, or they're just kids, so they are of no consequence to me. Those are the two ways to go about thinking. It is a question of, do you think children are people that you have responsibility for, that they're their own individuals who just need a little bit more care and guidance in life, or are children property, right? Yeah. They're just, you know, like without agency and undeserving of like basic decency and respect. And unfortunately, it seems that not only do these teachers fall under that camp, but the administrative staff seem to fall under that camp as well. Because, I mean, how did this not immediately lead to, like, honestly, like calling the police right there? Like, hey, oh, wow, you forced the kid to eat their own vomit. We are going to just have you arrested right here, right now on the spot. That's not even something where you're like, oh, we should have investigation, or we should figure out, we talk to the parents. Like, no, that's a pretty clear-cut case. You don't really need to have any investigation at that point. It's just, you know, getting the ball rolling so that the children feel safe. Because if there's that delay in timeline, then you have the children, right? Not only the individual child, but all the other children in school that have to sit there and wonder and question
that
whether or not all the adults are going to support them and protect them from things like this.
Yeah. I think, once again, you are on to all of it. These children were not afforded human rights, props in adult lives. If you don't want to clean up, throw up, or I didn't hear anybody say they got the child medical attention. Maybe it was just a gag. Maybe something else was going on. I didn't see any comfort, aid given here. Props in adult lives. Let me collect a check. And I really, you're right. They have the video. They have the footage. And if we could put up the mugshot, I guarantee this is not the face that these two, look how vulnerable they look, okay? The one screen left making, I don't know, making a pouty lift or something, but they seem so vulnerable. And I'm certain that's not how they stood on either side of this child. That's not the look that was on their faces. Couldn't be. I just find it disgusting, and you're right. When we stop looking at kids as property and props, and the fact that the kids weren't up in arms, and they weren't even afraid, apparently, that this child was going to tell. Who are you going to tell? It's like a prisoner. I just find it mind-boggling that we can't rid some of this out with a system of checks and balances that is ongoing. I'll give you the last word on this one, Bennie.
Yeah, I just think this speaks to like a desperate need in our society to stop collectively thinking of children as things that are just property, right? And to start recognize that children have agency. They are their own people. And sure, they need extra care in life, but we cannot just treat children as though they're the unquestioned property of parents, right? I mean, there's still tons of people that will get outraged at the idea that, like, hey, you shouldn't hit your kids. And they will talk like it's some sort of violation of their rights as parents, right, when people suggest that you don't hit your kids, right? And so collectively as a society, we just need more respect for children as human beings.
Couldn't agree more. My daughter, I sometimes don't like the way she speaks to me, and I do demand that you have to be respectful. Can we have a respectful conversation? But I am honored that she feels she can represent her views, even when she's frustrated. I'm just one parent.